Have you wondered if it's safe to fly? Well, so many of us wonder about that, right? That answer really depends, and it depends on so many things. But if you do choose to fly, I'm here to give you some tips that should hopefully make your flight a lot safer. The first thing is when you're shopping for airline tickets, don't just look at the price, okay? I know we all do that, but also look at the safety procedures that each airline is doing. Check out what different airlines are up to, what they're doing, how they're keeping their customers safe, and go with the airline that you feel most comfortable with. That's first thing. The second thing is avoid connecting flights if you can. The less connecting that you do, the safer it should be. And also, shorter flights are likely going to be safer than longer flights. So keep that in mind. The other thing to remember is that airlines are doing a lot to try to keep us safe. They are doing things like keeping the middle seat open in some cases. Many of them are doing temperature checks. They're disinfecting the planes thoroughly, before and after each flight. Many of them have touchless check-in, so you don't actually have to touch anyone or have anyone touch your things to check you in. And some airlines even have plastic barriers sort of between the seats, like sneeze guards, so that sneezes and coughs and things like that hopefully won't travel so much to the side. There are so many surfaces when walking into an airport that you can potentially touch. I don't know how else to say it, but try not to touch any. Just try not to touch anything. Keep your hands to yourself, as they say. Also, be very mindful as you're going through the security checkpoint. Try to stay 6 feet away from other people. Try to keep your distance, wear your mask, and all of this kind of stuff. Keep hand sanitizer with you. Make sure you hand sanitize after you touch things if you need to, like if you have to go to the restroom or you're ordering food or things like that before you get on the plane. Be mindful of sitting in restaurants or at tables in the airport area because they may not be the cleanest. You're going to have to make the decisions for yourself about what makes sense, but be mindful of all of these little points along the way. Now it is time to get on the plane. So what things can you do to make sure that your flight is as safe as possible? Well, first thing, I said it before, you got to be wearing your mask. I definitely recommend wearing your mask. You should be wearing your mask literally from, you know, the minute you get to the airport on, okay? Make sure you have that hand sanitizer in your pocket. I know I keep saying that. But the other thing is choose a window seat if possible. A window seat is going to keep you away from other folks a little bit more than, say, if you were in the middle or if you were on the aisle seat. So choose that window seat. Also, don't use your tray table unless you really, really have to, right? Don't use it. It can be filled with tons of germs. And if you do need to use it, pull out one of your antibacterial wipes. By the way, you may want to carry those with you, okay? Pull out a wipe and wipe it down before you actually use it. You also want to wipe down the little air vent if you turn that on too, which, by the way, that can be a good idea. And also make sure that you're disinfecting your hands after you touch these things. Another thing to consider is bringing your own food or drink onto the plane to eat. If you buy something from the concessions out in the airport, if you bring on your own food or drink, then you don't actually have to exchange anything with the airline folks that are bringing out the drinks and the food and things like that. It's maybe a little bit less contact. So that's something to consider as well. Something else I think is really important to know is what the CDC says. And they say that most viruses and germs don't spread easily on flights because of how air circulates on filtered airplanes. Well, that's a good thing, don't you think? Remember, whether you choose to fly or not is an individual decision. You have to take a lot of things into account, including some of the things I just mentioned. Guys, I hope this is helpful. Please share this video and like my page and follow it if you haven't already. I do daily health videos. If you're interested in sending stars, I answer your questions first. Guys, I am Dr. Jen Caudill. I will see you soon.